Hello, welcome to another edition of Bits and Banter, our weekly show on tech and business. This week, we'll discuss Riya Chakravarti. Sorry, that is just kidding, because we are not that type of a channel. We are going to discuss PUBG and its fallout in India. I mean, fallout of the ban in India. I mean, without much ado, we'll straight away go to Raj, who has done enough research on PUBG by not playing it. Go to Raj.
Yeah, thanks, Bala. You hit the nail on the head. It was the first time I saw PUBG, I thought it was a spelling mistake for Sub-G.
Oh, good.
I mean, you just change P with S, it looks like Sub-G, right?
Sub-G, so, which you and I like.
Yeah, we like, and nobody else in my house likes. Oh. So, yeah, so that is how my tryst with PUBG started off.
Being in Bangalore, PUBG should have rung a bell, something else.
Yeah,
for you, Raj.
Definitely. But since I don't go to the...
You're not a pub hopper.
No, I'm not. A pub hopper. I have a pub at home. So,
oh, great.
So I don't do that. Anyway, that is for another story at another time. So PUBG's, my link with PUBG started with when my son obviously is a techie and he started playing it. So as of now, so I wasn't surprised that the ban happened because to be honest, I'm sure all of you know, PUBG is actually not a Chinese brand. That's the place where we start. It is not a Chinese brand. It was started by a South Korean gaming company, which was surprisingly called Blue Hole. I really don't know what that means. But then, yeah, whatever it is.
Like many things we don't know.
Yeah, so this is another thing we don't know. So I thought it was a spelling mistake, but it turned out it was the right spelling. So anyway, and it was actually invented by a guy who was not even Korean. He was actually from some other nationality.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, how did it get banned in India? Because, before that, let me tell you that the PC version is still not banned. So, in case you want to play, you can play on the PC. You can download it. By the way, if you actually happen to have PUBG on your mobile, you can still play.
Ah, that's crazy, man. Yeah, I was about to get this.
Yeah, net result is it's only people like Bala and me who can't play because we didn't download it when we should have downloaded it. Even if we didn't want to play. Right?
Which is rather very convoluted. You might want to go back to that sentence again.
Yeah. I think if you didn't understand, I suggest just rewind and listen to it again. Which
exactly.
I'm sure is not a good idea because listening to us once itself is quite, you know what. So anyway. So we're not going there. So PUBG got banned because Tencent, which is a Chinese tech company and investor. Yeah. So now, why do they call themselves Tencent? Where is the remaining 90 cents? I have no idea. We'll try to find it and let you know when we find it, if we find it. So Tencent actually decided that they will join hands because they are fantastic at marketing and every damn app that comes onto the internet. So, and PUBG, in its mistaken belief that joining hands with a Chinese company is the best road to stardom, went with it and allowed Tencent to do the publishing of the mobile game only.
Exactly. PUBG Mobile.
Yes. So, it was PUBG Mobile that got banned. And so, there you are. So, that is how it got banned. Does it mean that it's a huge loss for India? Definitely not. Does it mean that it is a huge loss for people who play PUBG already? Definitely not. So
because they will anyway continue playing.
Yeah, they are playing. My son who quit PUBG when he, I don't know, when he probably found the pubs. Eventually. So he quit that. And the other day when I asked him, can you play? He said, yeah, I'm able to play. So he said, you want to play? I said, no, thank you very much.
That's because crazy, man. Well, then what is the ban all about?
Bala, it's one question about the ban. I can't, for the life of me, figure out why I would want to play a game where the basic idea is to sort of being airdropped at some weird place. You are one of the guys and then there are other people. So, you and I would be marooned on some island and we need to kill each other. Why the hell would I do that, man? So, that is a separate story. Okay, we'll keep it.
I mean, they call it is players unknown. Yes. Battleground.
Yeah.
So the battleground is unknown to you and me, Raj.
Yeah. And then we win when we kill each other, which is very unlike Snake and Ladder or Ludo, where the person who's winning doesn't have to kill the other person, right? And we sort of go ahead in life.
I mean, you're getting into the psychological aspect of a game like this. I mean, forget about the Indo-China problems. a lot of parents were actually happy that the PUBG, that the PUBG game was banned, because whether we like it or not, a lot of youngsters are addicted to it. Any kind of addiction brings with it as a lot of problems. Addiction is a problem. Any kind of addiction. This, I'm, as you rightly pointed out, the psychological aspects of this game. So this ban was welcomed by a lot of middle-class parents. So in that sense, beyond politics, there was a market for banning this PUBG. But now it seems the PUBG ban, I mean, one, it is not effective. And Tencent has also done something for making this ban infructuous. Yeah. Can you go on to that particular part?
Tencent hasn't done PUBG. They have decided, they have realized which side of their bread is buttered. Or which side of their pub is geed. I don't know whether we can do that. Yeah, so... horrible pun, but then whatever it is,
like mini puns.
So what they have done is they have asked Tencent to let go. They have told Tencent, you know what, maybe we'll give you the money that you deserve, so you just get off our backs so that we can publish the game, which basically means that their name would feature on the App Store and Play Store when you want to download PUBG. Assuming government of India says, oh yeah, that's a good idea now that the Chinese Tencent is not there.
I mean, does it make it go just, I mean, the Chinese factor was the problem?
Yeah, as of now, everything is related to the Chinese factor, I think. I mean, there's nothing else that seems to be defined. I mean, so anything...
Because we have a similar case in America also with TikTok, where the Chinese factor, once you take away the Chinese factor, if some US company takes over TikTok, suddenly it becomes kosher.
That's the point. So this is a China, anti-China thing more than anything else is what I feel. Although I totally agree with what you said, that I mean, if anything is becoming a habit to a point where it is all sort of taking away, taking you into
addiction.
Whether it is PUB or PUBG, both of them can be addictive, right? I mean, so we need to be careful about it. So, and PUBG is damn free. So, PUB you need to pay. So, you are slightly careful. You don't go towards the end of the month. PUBG you can play anytime, right?
So, see, the problem with... as you said, you can play PUBG. But the problem is this ban PUBG. Now, we are going to get into 4G.
Yeah, I know.
That is too pat and too... I mean... It is too ridiculous in the sense it's too pat, and it has come right on the back of a ban on PUBG, and the 4G has come. I mean, do you think there is something behind this, or it is just coincidental?
Yeah, so here is the thing. So 4G, it's not as if 4G was not in the works before the PUBG ban. 4G has been
It could not have been made overnight.
So 4G has been... So, I mean, there is this company called Encore Games, which works out of Bangalore. They have some decent games, as is wont, they were actually in the process of creating something like this. Just that when PUBG got banned, they realized that, okay, here is a space which we can sneak into.
Yeah, that's smart entrepreneurship.
Yeah, although whether it happens or not, it's anybody's, I would say it's anybody's guess.
Yes, because
there are already players who are actually taking up that space. So I don't see PUBG, or rather 4G, being the one which will take over. Having said that, 4G has an interesting perspective, which was something which attracted me. The perspective was that they would create these games not as killer takes all.
Okay.
Typically.
And it is not going to be a clone of PUBG.
Not at all. It is based on India's famous military
campaigns.
Yeah, and they're what they say is they are starting off with the Galwan Valley.
You have written about this, and I read that.
Yeah, so that is how they are starting. So to me, I mean, I'm quite a fan of every child knowing India's military history. So I mean, I strongly believe that military history, you can't sort of question the way you can question other history, because military history is I mean, it requires a lot of sign-offs by both parties. I mean, so for example, if India says that they lost 20 people and China says India lost 100 people, we know where the truth is. And China said they didn't lose anybody, but then now we know that they did lose some people in the clashes. So that's how
exactly.
It works. So I feel that is important. So if a game is taking us towards that, it makes a little bit of sense at least. That is.
But I have another view, Raj, and I want you to correct me if I'm wrong. In the sense, don't you think this will feed off the existing climate of jingoism, unfortunate jingoism that exists in India right now? So anything Indian military campaigns are sometimes overhyped in media, which doesn't understand these things. They don't have the nuance, or because when you go to a military person, he will not hype about the campaign. Yep. He'll talk matter-of-factly. Most of these Faujis, they talk matter-of-factly, but it is the media which gets into it, which doesn't understand these things. They tend to overhype these things. So it also feeds into the jingoism frenzy. Is that a possibility?
It is a possibility, definitely. Although I won't counter that. I would rather say that, can I have the facts out there? So if a game like Fauji is coming up, I mean, this is not the only clash. I mean, if you just look at the number of Paramveer Chakra awardees in the Indian Defence Forces, if you can actually tell all their stories in the form of a game, I think that makes a lot more sense. Because even for the people who are jingoistic, when they realize that, you know what, some of these jingoisms that happened were not as they were presented. I mean, like you said, the army never talks jingoism. The army is extremely army. All the defense forces, they're extremely...
they have a kind of an equanimity because they see life and death in a quite literally.
Yeah, which is why, I mean, just to sort of take a slight... U-turn, I felt, detour. I found that movie on Gunjan Saxena to be doing credit to everyone except Gunjan Saxena, sadly.
That's sad.
Happened. We'll discuss that some other time. I think we discussed it randomly once. But then, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
So this is what I feel. I think it is just a question of the right time. Although, because if you want to release a good game, it takes you more than 6 months. So to assume that...
That's minimum. Yeah, because you need more than that.
More than that. I mean, 6 months of complete devotion. I mean, where the entire team is working on that, which usually doesn't happen, actually.
But some of these gaming companies, you find such nerds working on it. They
Mm-hmm. Gaming companies are full of nerds. Gaming companies can work only when you have single-minded... I don't know. I mean,
single-minded madness. I put it that way.
I mean, you are only thinking gaming. So, gaming. I feel that is true. Now, the comedy would be whether... Now imagine all of this happens and suddenly PUBG returns.
That is a possibility.
Then what happens? Then will Akshay Kumar continue to promote 4G? Or would he think that, okay, he would rather promote 4G on screen and not in games? One doesn't know. I think we'll wait for another episode and another time to sort of discuss that.
We'll get back to our real life following Riya Chakravarti and Kangana Ranaut's stories, which is what does. That's and a different kind of a...
Either way, I mean, just to sort of wind this up, I would say if all these news anchors in this country were given PUBG and kept busy, I think news will get better. What do you say?
Exactly. But if you watch some of these channels, suddenly PUBG seems much more realistic, much more sane.
Yeah, I guess so.
So, okay. On that note, we'll finish off for this week.
Yes. So,
thanks, folks, for watching.
Yeah. Keep your comments coming, if at all, and keep watching and sharing your views with us. We'll see you next week. Take care and stay safe. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Eid Young, King Khan, Yo-Yo Honey Singer.